all YouTubers, you are subscribed, and everybody on the remaining social network. This is Dark King, and today, welcome to another episode of Manga Abridged. Today, we're going for One Piece 889. An unknown mama. Funny. On a written note, we found Weho and the rest of the dwarves looking like parrots. That's hilarious. And today, Viola and Rebecca agree. The chapter proper begins exactly where we left off, with SSJ Carrot going wild with the rest of the ships, and Daifuku not finding that amusing at all, as he unleashes his genie and starts actually doing more damage than Carrot. Go figure. We then cut back to Straw Hats giving us a play-by-play of the massacre aboard Daifuku's fleet. Then we have Professor Jinbei enlightening us of the consequences of the Sail Lion form. As it seems, this form is akin to Super Saiyan 3 more than raw Super Saiyan, as its use has drastic stamina and life force consequences. Many can only be used in short bursts. With that little amount of world building and exposition aside, Brook steps up, as he uses his bona fide body to do the classic yo-ho-ho on water, attempting to go support Carrot. And so, we cut back to Big Mom herself, still in the candy slug and looking rather starved. Huh. It seems it's been 8 hours since this whole mess started, and she's certainly suffering the consequences. Also, she's calling for Prometheus, Zeus, and... where the heck are they? What is it? Question will have to wait, as a fodder character from the Big Mom Pirates is informing Perro Sparrow that, well, the cake's coming, but is on Veggie's ship. Yeah! And like any good proper second command would say, the cake is gonna be sabotaged. Though, it probably won't, as we cut out to Sanji and Pages discussing that exact topic. With Beiju wanting to take another crack at poisoning Big Mom, and Sanji saying him to go to hell and back. Discussion seems amusing, but Sanji is having none of it, and so he runs the point and a spoon of sweet sweet marvelous cream right down Beiju's throat. Insert pudding, technically not pudding, more pudding joke here, and so with Beiju still suffering from that sweet sweet sweetness, he allows the cake to continue undisturbed. Oh, right! Those two. Well, Zeus and Prometheus are going to Big Mom, though Zeus isn't exactly going off scot-free as Prometheus is chastising him all the way. Now, getting back to the Sunny and the gang, well, the Big Mom pirates are having a serious hump problem as Carrot is going from ship to ship to ship, just ripping every single one of them off, along with Daifuku quite literally. Cutting the ship in half. Clever. But even so, Carrot is starting to feel the burden of SSJ3, with Brook arriving just in time to save Carrot. As with her stamina almost gone, Brook is piggybacking her while she shoots her eyes from the moonlight in order to go back to base form, right to the Sunny, where the gang is really, really happy that she could do that. With Carrot just asking if she can get in the room to recuperate from the SSJ3 consequences. On a related note, well, Prometheus and Zeus have arrived. What does that have to do with SSJ3? Yeah, that's a thing. Huh. Ah. And with the Big Mom Pirates apparently never seeing her like that, she comes. She holds onto the Sunny, and yeah. And that's where the chapter ends. With Chopper and Nami getting their rectums ready for a proper raping, Carrot still suffering the consequences, Brook cracking his bones for round two, and acting Captain Jinbei, ordering the crew to get ready to abandon ship. So, this was quite an interesting chapter. We found out more about the Sail Lion's form, and that the mix can't keep it up for long. Quite a different spin for when they use it in Wano. It's not a blunt claw, but a spear that needs to be aimed at the heart of the enemy. So, even if you have an army of minks that can do that, they won't be able to keep it up for long, you know, unless you'll have to try keep the bucket. Which I wouldn't push past it. Remember, we're gonna be fighting Kaido next year. And, well, Big Mom went Super Saiyan 3. That's a thing. I actually didn't expect her to fuse with Prometheus. Like, at all. But again, it's Zelda. We should always expect the unexpected. Now, Luffy versus Katakuri this episode. Well, I guess it will be a good way to start next year. If I'm not mistaken, next week there isn't gonna be a chapter. The chapter didn't say it, but it's the last week of the year. If I'm not mistaken, usually they don't come out. Anyway, still, seeing Carrot kicking ass and Brook proving once again that he can be the MVP of this arc. Good chapter. And for emphasizing Sanji's commitment as a cook and that those 2 years in the hell he went through his own personal hell. It proved fruitful, most definitively. Also, I'm quite curious what's gonna happen next. I mean, the Sunny won't be sunk, so how are they going to get out of this one? Anyway, people, I hope you enjoyed this, and until next time, don't forget to like, subscribe, and, well, you know the drill. Until then, I'll see you around. Ta-ta!